extraordinaire.
Good morning, Gregory Howard. Thanks for having me and taking my call.
Hey, Nydia, this is David Hancock.
Oh, hello, David Hancock. Great to hear you, too.
And Jay Torrance. Hi, Nydia. How are you?
Hello, Jay Torrance. I'm doing well. Thank you so much. I have a concern I'd like to share with you today, and that is a proposed amendment to what's known as the Rule 22, which controls recording devices in the courtrooms in Georgia, and it controls cameras and audio recorders and any recording device you might bring into a courtroom. And the Council of Superior Court Judges has proposed changes to this rule, and it would limit recording to only when the judge is actually seated on the bench, and it would also limit recording to not allow coverage of the attorneys and clients together sitting at their table, and perhaps for fear of getting any confidential conversation. My opinion is that the courtroom and the courthouse is the public's house. It's a public space. It belongs to the public. And because of that, the public should be afforded access to that space and what goes on in a courtroom. And the media covers judicial proceedings and hearings, and they share with the citizens what's going on in their justice system. And if the media is not allowed to film when the judge is not on the bench, they would miss the accused entering the courtroom before the judge has arrived, or when a verdict has been rendered, the reaction of the audience inside the courtroom. The judge may be off the bench by that time. And I think it's a very narrow restriction that should not be imposed upon the media, who has been granted permission to video record and audio record a hearing. And so
I can see the concern I have. You could argue that, okay, maybe the needs are reasonable, but like we started the show out with, this is not heading in the right direction. You know, if this gets through, then what's next?
Agreed. It's just limiting our rights of speech and press and coverage, and our right to know as citizens what our government is doing. I posted a very thorough blog yesterday about the proposed amendments to Rule 22, and that's on my website called aboutforsyth.com, and Forsyth is spelled Forsyth. Again, aboutforsyth.com. And it's called Changes to Rule 22 Controlling Cameras in the Courtroom in Georgia, which I'm most concerned that it's going to curtail media coverage. I've also put it on my Twitter page. I've been tweeting about that quite a bit. And my Twitter handle is at Nydia Tisdale. And that's spelled N like Nancy, Y-D-I-A, T like Tom, I-S-D-A-L-E, at Nydia Tisdale. So if one has an interest and would like to comment to the Superior Court Council, you can, and they are receiving comments up until Monday, July the 3rd, 2017. So if any comment is received after that date, it will not be considered. So we're right up against the deadline. This issue has been covered wonderfully by the Atlanta Journal-Constitution. Chris Joyner wrote an article on it. Also, the Daily Report, Robin McDonald, wrote an article about this proposed rule change, and I have links to those articles on my blog post as well. So I think the citizens need to pay attention to this. The media needs to pay attention to this. Lawyers need to pay attention to this, because I have filmed in multiple courtrooms, multiple cases over the years, and I believe that everyone is on their best behavior when there is a camera recording one's actions. And I think
that
it's very important.
Is there a backstory to this where the judges have been embarrassed or caught doing something wrong, or courtroom procedures that have led to this?
I don't know what has led to the rule change, but there have been cameras that have caught a judge who was basically shaking down defendants, demanding payment for fines immediately, or he would put them in prison. And that was actually covered by the New York Times, and that... Well, I don't know that detail, but an article, the surreptitious courtroom video props changes in a Georgia town. And so that, yes, there has been some wrongdoing caught from video recordings in courtrooms. But it's also helpful for citizens to know what to expect when they arrive in a courtroom. What is the procedure? What happens inside these courtrooms? It belongs to us. It's the public's house, and we have a right to know that.
Yeah, those who don't know Nydia, she has relentlessly and fearlessly and tirelessly for years filmed everything she can get hold of, politicians, courtroom proceedings, anything, and made it available for anybody. So I can't go downtown and watch some hearing, but, you know, 9 times out of 10, Nydia is going to be there recording it and putting it up, and I can go and see exactly what happened. And I thank you so much for your, you know, giving access to so many people for so many places that are, like you say, our government, our public, our people, our tax dollars.
And that's why I say activist extraordinaire, because they've attacked her.
Oh, yeah.
Physically, you know, she's paid the price for, often for us.
Nydia, can you tell us who is responsible for leading the charge to change this Rule 22?
I wish I knew, and I just don't. It's peculiar to me. Because it's been in place for maybe 30 years and there's been no issue, no problem with it, no changes, and now all of a sudden this has been introduced. And there's been a comment period available for several months now, but again, the deadline is Monday, July 3rd, if one wants to contribute a comment.
So who decides whether it goes into effect?
Yeah, that's the question that I have as well.
It is the Council of Superior Court Judges, and I'll repeat, the Council of Superior Court Judges, and I'm not that familiar with that council to be able to address your questions.
Sure. And to address this, to voice our concern, do you go to their website, or they go to yours, and you get the directions there?
You may fax a comment to them. Their fax number is 404-651-8626. Repeat, their fax number is 404-651-8626. And comments must be received again by Monday. And yes, I have over 1,000 videos on my YouTube channel, which is, again, youtube.com/Nydia Tisdale. And I've filmed public events of public interest, of public officials doing the public's business. And I think it's important information that people need to have access to.
In this film, a lot of our meetings, I love having her there. She, when we have, like, Sam Owens, you want to record him. And like you said, Nydia, that puts them on. They realize, people might really hear what I say. So they have to be a little bit better behavior and think about what they're saying.
Certainly agreed. And actually, I filmed Sam Owens on Monday night this past week at the Kennesaw State University workshop with the Georgia First Amendment Foundation and the Society of Professional Journalists, the KSU chapter. And that video is available on my website and on my YouTube channel. And it was just very informative about our Sunshine Laws, the Open Meetings Act, and the Open Records Act, which Sam Owens had as his campaign platform when he was running for Georgia Attorney General. He resigned his position to become president of KSU last year. One other thing I want to share with your listeners is that I was, in fact, arrested while video recording a public event. It was a political campaign rally in 2014 in Dawson County at Burt's Pumpkin Farm. And I have a calendar call on Monday, July 3rd, to set a possible trial in the beginning of August, the first week of August. So almost 3 years later, that case is still in the courts. I'm still being prosecuted by the Dawson County District Attorney Lee Dara and Conley Greer for sitting silently, holding a video camera, filming our elected officials and our candidates running for office at an open to the public rally in Dawson County on Burt's
Farm. Where did you ask for permission, by the way?
I spoke with the property owner when I first arrived. We had a lovely conversation. I explained who I was. We introduced ourselves to each other, and I explained that I would be filming the rally, and she replied, okay. I think everyone was in shock by the very physical and violent arrest by Captain Tony Wooten. I'll repeat his name, Captain Tony Wooten. He has since stepped down from the Dawson County Sheriff's Office. He no longer works there. Yes, he was running for sheriff. The incumbent sheriff, Billy Carlisle, was resigning from office, and it was an open seat. There were four candidates. Tony Wooten was a top vote getter in the primary election. However, he lost to Jeff Johnson in the runoff election. And I covered that campaign. I would attend the public debates and video recorded them and posted them on YouTube as well. So he was very aggressive with me. He frog marched me out of the rally, twisted my arm behind my back, slammed me up against the checkout counter, which was stationary. It did not budge. He pushed his full weight against me. He shoved his crotch into my buttocks and held me there until other officers, deputies arrived. They both work. Actually, it's Council of Superior Court Judges. The Supreme Court of Georgia has been very open to their cameras, and they video record their arguments in their courtrooms. So the Supreme Court is very transparent and very agreeable to cameras in their courtroom. This change is for the Superior Court Judges.
Thank you so much. For calling in. We're behind you 100%.
Oh, thank you very much. And enjoy talking with all of you this morning. Have a great day.
All right, we can.
And happy 4th of July.